Doc, the other day you said Big Bang is only a theory and that we need to wait till it becomes a fact. Can you throw more light on this subject? I and my friend Joe have been perplexed ever since you made that statement.
Doc, after all science is science and all fact is fact. So why do you reject such things? I am totally perplexed.
Susan and Joe, I appreciate your questions. It is true that all science is science and all facts are facts. However, such a broad statement is insufficient to understand the true nature of science. You need to realize that science is a vast enterprise, with many categories of information. While all of them are part of the scientific enterprise, not all categories of information have same weight or reliability. I will invite my fellow researcher Dr. Simpson to throw some light on this subject.
Susan and Joe, Dr. Philip told me that both of you are keen students of truth, so let us look at science from an analytical angle. Actually, science is that human enterprise where humans try to acquire objective information about the universe. By objective I mean information that depends only upon facts. Scientists gather as much information about a given subject as possible. They also gather such information from as wide a region as possible. The aim is to take all possible information into consideration. No information is ignored or suppressed. Once all possible data is gathered, it is sifted and sorted. It is classified and then analyzed. Charts are made, graphs are drawn. Everything is compared with what others might have done on the same subject before. In this way, a clear picture of cause and effect relationship is discovered. At this stage, the work is systematically written down so as to communicate the method, the data, the analysis, and the deduction to others. It is then sent to scholarly journals for publication. Learned referees and editors check the research paper for its accuracy and possible value to advance scientific knowledge. The paper is seen by thousands, many of whom independently check and verify the deductions. They tally it with their own work. Feedback is given. In this way, a scientific consensus is born out of objective analysis at every stage. As you can see, discovery of scientific information is a long process. It involves many steps and many people. It involves not only data and deduction, but it also involves many categories of information. Now, I hand over the discussion to Dr. Philip, who will explain the rest of it to you.
From what Dr. Simpson said, it is obvious to both of you that science is the end product of a systematic study of matter and energy. Today, scientific studies are a massive undertaking. Some science laboratories have a few researchers. Others have tens of thousands of people working for them. The collective output of these people is known as science, as Dr. Simpson said. You need to know that many categories of information are involved in this process. A large number of categories of information that I will explain to you. I am sure that both of you have heard words like observation, data, assumption, interpretation, hypothesis, theory, school of thought, facts, laws, models, etc. These are all words related to science. They represent various types of information. Science needs all of them to attain the best possible information. You know that bricks, mortar, timber, and steel are needed to build a house. However, they in themselves are not the house. Similarly, all these categories are needed as building blocks, but not all of them represent the final stage of scientific information. Is that clear, Susan and Joe?
Yes, Doc, I do understand now that science is not a single entity. Rather, it is the final product of a large categories of truth. Some of these categories might contain only a primitive look into truth. I also realize the primitive understanding might mature into something totally different from what it was to start with.
Yes, Doc, I too now understand that science is not a single entity. It is a continually growing activity where knowledge increases progressively and in step. This means that some categories of scientific information might not be as accurate or reliable as other categories. I realize that we need to distinguish between these categories when we talk about science and scientific information.
Of convenience, we can call all of them together as the theories of science. Theories are an essential part of science, but they do not represent the pinnacle of truth. Theories are not the final stage because they often get modified in the light of further research. On the other hand, there are observations, facts, and laws of science. For the sake of convenience, we can call all of them together as the facts of science. So now we have two major groups, the theories of science and the facts of science. Theories of science keep changing. They do not represent the final stage of science. On the other hand, the facts of science represent the final level of scientific information where information remains stable. This distinction has great importance for those who study Bible and science. I will request Dr. Simpson to explain the rest of it to you. I am confident that by now it is obvious to both of you that all scientific information is made up of unestablished theories of science as well as proven facts of science. No unestablished theory of science can ever be used as evidence anywhere. Only established facts of science can be used as evidence. Coming to the question of Bible and science, we need to remember that only established facts of science can be used to examine statements of the Bible. Susan and Joe, if this fact is clear to both of you, I will ask Dr. Philip to conclude this presentation.
Yes, Dr. Simpson, it is clear to me that science is not a single or uniform entity. Rather, the science of any generation is a mixture of unestablished theories plus established facts. Both of them are essential for the development of science, but they do not have the same level of reliability.
Me too, Dr. Simpson. I now understand that the non-established theories of science cannot be used to examine the Bible. If they contradict the Bible, I do not have to worry about it because a theory does not represent final scientific truth. On the contrary, only established facts of science can be used to examine the Bible. I am now ready to hear what more Dr. Philip has to say on this issue.
So here is the final picture. Theories of science are non-established scientific information. So they cannot be used to examine statements in the Bible. Only established facts of science can be used for such purpose. When this is done, we discover that no established fact of science has ever contradicted any statement of the Bible. At the same time, no statement of the Bible has ever contradicted an established fact of science. Now our discussion started with the Big Bang. Since the scientific name itself is Big Bang Theory, and not Big Bang Law, you need to understand that it is a non-established theory. As long as it remains a non-established theory, Christians do not have to worry about it. A non-established theory cannot be used to question a witness like the Bible. No court of law would allow any witness to use a theory to argue their case. Let me summarize our discussion. When facts of science are used to examine the statements of the Bible, no contradiction is ever found. Since Big Bang is a theory, as the name itself says, it cannot be used to examine the Bible. A lot of people love to use one theory or another to question or attack the Bible. The first thing that you need to ask in such case is this person using a theory of science or a fact of science? If you do not ask this most important question, you will simply keep moving in a confusing maze. This is exactly what those who attack the Bible want from you. But the moment you ask the right question, you will come out of the confusing maze. Most of the Bible and science confusion arise only because Christians do not ask the right question to come out of the maze. So Susan and Joe, start asking the right question so as to find the right solution. Here is a word of advice to all who have been watching this animation. No unestablished theory of science can ever be used to examine or contradict the Bible. As a result, the Big Bang Theory does not contradict the Bible. Let it first become an established fact before anyone can even think of using it against the Bible. We have a very large number of animations on all aspects of Bible, science, evolution and the logical reliability of the Christian faith. Please be sure to watch all of them.